A bit of history for dome enthusiasts. This video is of the very first monolithic dome. It was inflated April 5th, 1976. As we were going through the history of this, we thought it would be fun to quote some of the things that Dad wrote in his book, Think Round, The Story of David B. South and the Monolithic Dome. So I hired a local engineer to do the thin shell engineering. At the time, I didn't realize what a benefit he was. That engineer hand calculated the whole thing. About 8 pages of facts and figures that I gave to the Federal Land Bank, who agreed to the loan. I then applied to my local bank and borrowed against the commitment from the Federal Land Bank. What Dad had been doing before this was he was foaming and insulating potato storages, and he really was excited about domes, and so he was going to build this first dome using his Cat air systems that were designed specifically to store potatoes well. And that's what that center column is that you're seeing in the video. That was his air system that was used to keep the air moving through the potatoes. Incidentally, they actually used that to inflate the dome as well, so there's no separate inflation system on this project. So let's continue with Dad's book. I began searching for a company to make the airform and finally found a company called Sidna in California. Sidna's president agreed to build the airform, providing I gave him the specifications. When I told him what the airform was for, he told me I was crazy, but he'd build it anyway. I like that. That trial airform was made of material vastly lighter than what we use today. Instead of an airlock, it had a zipper, but it inflated properly. We tied it to the foundation with a drawstring, much like a drawstring on a bag. It was fun to read about Dad and his drawstring method and how that ended up being kind of a disaster. One of the next domes they built, the airform had come off the footing and blown into an apple orchard that was next to the job site, and they had to go carefully peel this airform off of all these apple trees. That would have been not a fun job. So continuing with his book, he says, building that trial dome proved a comedy unto itself. Instead of the rebar that we use today, our original engineering provided reinforcement with a mesh fabric, a welded wire mesh commonly known as 66-1010 mesh. We measure our air pressure with a magnahelic, and I guesstimated just about everything we did, even the 2 inches of air pressure. But we got it inflated and foamed. The foam presented no problem, and somehow we got the mesh placed. Then we started spraying concrete. I engaged a Salt Lake City firm that sprayed shotcrete in tunnels to do the shotcrete spraying. But the crew sent to us had very little experience. They used a Thompson concrete pump that was new on the market to spray in place concrete. Also a relatively new product. Simply not a lot was known about either the pump or the concrete. We worked for 3 or 4 days with practically no good results. I called the boss in Salt Lake, bought the pump, and sent the crew home. Then Barry, Randy, and I began teaching ourselves the art of concrete spraying. I designed that first monolithic dome with a diameter of 105 feet and a height of 35 feet. Furnished it with a Cat air system, and rented it to a farmer for his 5 million potatoes in Idaho. Now, South's Inc. was not only insulating potato storages, but constructing them. I wonder if Dad knew then the kind of business that he was kicking off and how it's grown today.